Noch ein sehr interessantes Gespräch, hoffe ich zumindest, mit Chris Grove von Commerce Resources, auch ein Unternehmen, das unseren Lesern von Gold Invest schon lange bekannt ist. Es gab in der letzten Zeit einige interessante Entwicklungen. Wir sprechen heute mal nicht so sehr über die seltenen Erden, sondern über Tantal und Niob. Chris, welcome. It's good to see you again.
Danke, danke. Good to be here again.
I think we last spoke in Munich, really, to be honest. So it's been a while. A couple of months, and there's been some quite interesting things happening. One is on the tantalum project you've had for a while, and already has a PA on it, if I'm ready.
That's correct.
If I'm correct. So tell us, what's been happening there?
In terms of the tantalum project, there's a recent development in a story that goes back to 2006. So in that year, we were approached by the president of Stillwater Mining and his head geologist and a metallurgist who had worked for Silmet in Estonia for 30 years at that point. He approached us with the intent, or the group approached us with the intent of setting up a processing facility on site at our Blue River deposit using this new lower cost process for tantalum and niobium ores. In terms of that, at that point in time, the metallurgist did not have his US patents in place. And so over the last decade, that was one of the things that he was working on. And now that he had received his US patents, he then reached out to us last year. Now, having said that, the news release that came out in July of last year, we disclosed that we were sending him a sample to his facility in Estonia, 1,300 kilograms of material from our deposit. Later in the fall, he contacted us and said the processing had been completely successful. And he made the suggestion then, which was a very good suggestion, to send our chairman of the board, Dr. Axel Hoppe, the former COO of the world's largest tantalum consumer and processor, the German company H.C. Stark, to his facility in Estonia to confirm and verify these results. So we did that in 2018, third week of January, and we were very excited, I was very excited, to receive an email from our chairman, Dr. Hoppe, in capital letters with exclamation points saying, this process works, and now our opportunity, our chances to get our Blue River project into production has gone up 1,000%. So we're in the process right now of negotiating the global rights to this technology. Now, Dr. Krupen, the metallurgist, wants this essentially to be his legacy, to have a Krupen process facility on site at our deposit. And we want the same thing. Ultimately, this process, at a rough estimate, would save us perhaps in the range of 25% of processing costs. Now, having said that, standard processing already had us as significantly cash positive, and so this new lower cost process will make that margin arguably even higher. Obviously, we look forward to the next steps for this. Obviously, we look forward to then using these economics, which will then be verified in a pilot plant, 43-101 compliant, of course, and have these economics out in a pre-feasibility study. So we're very excited about this. Having said that, the other side of it is that there really are no new tantalum and niobium projects that have come into operation and are still in operation in the last generation. In terms of that as well, the niobium demand is going up by about 10% per annum. If any of your listeners know the world's tallest bridge, the Mio Viaduct in France, that bridge arguably was not possible to be built without niobium alloyed steel. And at the end of the day, with this growing demand and no new producers of niobium, there's a real opportunity there for us as well.
Well, there we are, niobium. We have been talking about rare earth this time, but close to your ASHRAM rare earth project, you came across some niobium too, and are going to do a few exciting things with that.
Yes, thank you very much for asking me about that. Now, in terms of what we have in Blue River, we have a resource of 200 million pounds of niobium and approximately 23 million pounds of tantalum in a resource. In terms of other niobium showings that are proximal to our ashram deposit in Quebec, we have released many samples that range from 1% up to 5.9% niobium. Now, 5.9% niobium is 10 times the mining grade of the world's second largest niobium mine, Niobec, which is also in Quebec, and 5.9% is double the high grade of the world's largest niobium project, which is called Araxá, run in Brazil by CBMM. In terms of our second most recent news release, this was about our decision to allow a very friendly company called Seville Resources to do an earn-in agreement on these niobium areas that are basically right next door to the Ashram project. So, Seville Resources is run by Mike Hodge, and he will be doing a financing and will be looking to do a drill program on these niobium claims with the intent of proving up a niobium resource on these claims. And I'm very excited about the possibility that he will prove up something that is at potentially much better than the Niobec mine in Quebec.
Well, it's early stages there, though, and we'll have to see how it goes, but that could be very interesting for you, for sure. I think so, too. Also, how has the show been? Has that been interesting? Has that been fruitful? Have you had good meetings?
We've had very good meetings. In essence, we've had meetings on all three of our projects, let me say right now. So a significant amount of the meetings was with regards our Blue River project in terms of this new Dr. Crouppen's process that we are working with at this point. And then we had many meetings, including with the Quebec government, on our rare earth element project in Quebec. And in terms of that, I would love to show you this map, which is from the Quebec, yes, which is from the Quebec government. And on a list of mining projects that are being worked on right now, the list of commodities is down here on the right-hand side. And at the bottom, you see the commodity rare earth elements, and you only see one project. There we are. We are the only rare earth element project listed on the government of Quebec's own map. And as you see as well, basically from the 54th parallel north, we are the only project in that area right now on this map, which is not necessarily accurate, but it is a nice compliment. The reality is one of the things that we have been working on and hopefully we'll see some forward movement on is a road that we essentially worked on for the last 4 to 5 years. Okay. The reality about that road is that there's at least 7 other companies with projects proximal to this road. And in that regard, we have gotten them all to sign a letter of intent saying that if a road was to be built in this area, they would use the road. So in terms of moving ahead on our rare earth element project, yes, we would need a road, but having in total 8 or more companies also being able to use this road, that potentially creates an opportunity for this road to be financed collectively, potentially with involvement from the Quebec government as well. We are hopeful.
Certainly would help, yes. Yes. So it sounds like you're going to have a very busy year in front of you, and I hope we'll see some of that come to fruition this year and see how it goes, and we'll check in later, see how it went.
Well, thank you very much. And before I leave you, the fundamental points that are probably the most important is that the commodity prices. So with rare earth elements having seen falling prices since March of 2011, basically 7 years of falling prices, during that time, although global majors have expressed their interest in us, that interest is become much more acute in the last several months because prices have started appreciating significantly. So global majors that have reached out to us have said the same two things. One, they're worried about future supplies of rare earth elements, and two, they do not want to have to depend upon Chinese sources. So I believe we're in a very strong position. It's a very interesting market right now, and I very much look forward to success on some of these initiatives.
and we'll be sure to get an update. Thank you.
You are very welcome. Vielen Dank.